our Barney winners, and they're coloring. Yay! I don't know what it is about Barney. Everyone starts going like this. George is over there going like this because Barney does that. Look at all of you, and it's the girl winners today. Look at all these girls.
They're beautiful.
And this was by random choice too.
It is. It's just because of their coloring talent, really.
Maybe.
We have done a contest. We talked about it the last, little while. And we had you color pictures, or had your children color pictures, send them in, and then we randomly drew the winners. But Barney is coming on Tuesday, and these five girls are going to the concert. They won four tickets for their family, and they also won a Barney DVD.
Oh, let's hold that up right here.
Oh, look.
This is what you guys get to take home. Oh,
Who's this? So we have Riley, Callista, Ruby,
and then Alexis and Adelaide.
Okay. How does Barney make you feel?
Good.
Good. Tell me about Barney.
He's purple.
He's purple. Does he sing? Do you like to sing some of the songs?
Okay. Sing me a Barney song. Can you sing me a Barney song?
I love you. You love me.
Oh, she's got it.
How about this one, guys? You want to sing, oh, Mr. Sun.
Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me.
This segment isn't for the kids, people.
No, it's for all the moms out there. Sing along, audience.
Okay, who likes Barney the best? Barney? Who likes Baby Bop the best?
I like Baby Bop.
Who's the new one? Riff?
Riff? Like
have you met Riff yet?
He's going to be there on Tuesday when you guys get to go.
You like Barney?
Yes. Yeah.
What are you coloring here? What is that right there that you're coloring?
Is that a monster?
It looks like a rock star.
Two of them?
Two.
Yes.
What do you want to say to Barney when you see him on Tuesday?
The TV.
You're going to see him on the TV first? Are you going to see him in person when you get to go to the show?
Yeah.
What do you want to say to Barney? I love you. Everybody wants to say I love you to the dinosaur.
It's not too late to get Barney tickets. You can still go to Barney. These girls are going for free because of their coloring talent. But it's going on at the E Center. It's 7 o'clock on Tuesday. It's the Let's Go Live tour. And tickets are available at the E Center box office or at Smith Ticks. So you can log on to our website to find out more information at abc4.com. Girls, wonderful job. Have fun at Barney.
Mom, don't leave us yet.
Okay, she's like, I've done my work here. I'm gone.
Oh, you want color over here?
You're going to color over with your new friends over here, huh?
Yeah.
Thank you, girls, for being on the show and for coloring. Congratulations.
Good job.
All right, stick around, everyone. Vern Yip has got the coolest artwork you've ever seen, and you can do it yourself with all the fall leaves. Love strawberries, we all love salad, but what if you put them together? I'm in the kitchen with my favorite friend, Angel Shannon, and we have
a viewer's recipe today from Brooke Beavis, who actually happens to be in our audience today.
There she is.
Very pretty Brooke of Salt Lake City, and it's strawberry salad. And when my kids were really little, they didn't call them strawberries, they called them straw babies. So we still call them straw babies in my house.
So it would be straw baby salad.
Say, Grandpa, what big teeth you have.
That's funny.
Watch me, Grandma.
Okay, you do it.
Okay. It's too hard.
Hello. Mr. Mede. Hi. Can you throw me a kiss? Go.
Hi, Daddy. Bring me a kiss.
Say bye-bye. Here's the new baby, Austin. He's about 3.5 weeks old. 3 weeks and 2 days. Kind of looks like Todd there, huh? He's about that tall. 20-something inches, probably. He was 7 pounds, half an ounce. He's doing pretty good. Looks like he just ate because he's pretty quiet and pretty happy. Gee, I wonder what that is. A pacifier holder. From Todd and Shelly and Cindy and Kim. Well, excuse me, not Kimberly. But it's good to have Mom and Dad here. They took care of Remington while I went to the temple this week. Just got back today. Todd, this is Austin. It's a good thing we had another boy. We've got all the clothes still. Do you have anything you'd like to say, Mom and Dad?
Well, we're doing just fine. We got all our stuff put away in our new house, and everything's going all good.
Good. Now it's our turn. It's hard to keep him happy because he just spits the pacifier out of his mouth. Hi. Remington wants to get kid help, yeah.
Remington.
Jerry asks, when do his eyes open? Yeah, when he's in the hospital, he's just joking. And we told Lana's mom that he said that. She says, was he kidding? He was kidding, wasn't he? Yeah, he likes Grandma and Grandpa.
Oh, he doesn't either. Grandma's not holding him right. There. Say hello to Todd and Shelly and Cindy and Kim.
Cool. Say hi. We taught him how to say hi.
Likes his pacifier, you guys. Must have honey on it.
Isn't he cute? Doesn't he remind you of yourself, Todd? Does he look like a Hale or more like a Montgomery this time? Thank you, Ram.
He looks like Remington.
Yeah, he does.
Like Remington did.
Huh, can you wink?
Can you wink at Daddy?
Wink at Daddy.
Wink.
There he goes.
I haven't seen him all day. Huh. Hang on, you're falling.
Woo, hold on.
What a nut.
Shelly?
Oh, Shelly? Sorry. Of course we need to get Shelly. And,
This is the family.
This is the whole thing. Now you can see me and not just hear my voice. Catch Remington. That's the menace.
Oh, but he was a good little guy. He's pretty good.
Scouts came over tonight and brought some brownies and sweatshirts. And I got you a sweatshirt to give you. And we're just trying to get rid of John. Yeah, Dad, just let it go now.
Now it's on.
Now it's on. It'll stay on until you press it again.
Here's an early scene. Velma and Don, Coyote Park, San Mateo, about 1951. There's Don Gilchrist and a friend of Don's. These scenes are from our patio in a home we had in Belmont, taken about 1954. We had a get-together, and I forget really what the celebration of the day was, but most of the family members from this area was represented. I believe Velma and Don were already there, too. Scene of Jess and Rhonda. These are newlyweds. There's Nadine. A few early scenes of Jack and Martha at their home on Valota Road in Redwood City. It was Jack's car. I bet he wished he had it back today. There's Lorinda. And the next member of the family was Martha, and Brent was there in spirit only. Here's a short scene of Bill and Melba visiting us in Golden Gate Park, 1953. Here's Jess and Denny. Also at the same time was a picture of Mom and ours. This was after they was married. They'd come down to visit us. There's Timmy Bankson out front. And there's Leela and Kim. Brian Duffy there, and Kim. And the two sisters, Isla and Leela. Spirit Lake out west of Port Angeles. We now go to Twin Falls, 1952, and here's the house on 3rd West. That's my old Buick out in front. It was new then. Here's a scene of Mom just coming home from work. Here was a picture of Mom and ours before they was married. Here's a picture of Zet and Isla. This also was before she was married. And the two boys, Tim and Tom. Hey boys, stay off the fence. That was the favorite word we always heard while we was there. You guys get off the fence. We now shift our location over to Don and Velma's old home. This is on Quincy. There's the master of the house right now. Benita. The baby of the family at the time. Velma Jean. Donald Jr., I might say, and Velma Jean doing a little entertainment for us, drum majoretting. This is a scene out at Banbury Hot Springs. That was Vanita in the scene. There's a distant one of Patty, Denton, and Arzetta that was there at the time. And guess who's got the sunburn? Oh, I bet that felt good that night. Now shift to the ranch out in Elba. This is a scene from up on the grade looking down the valley towards Elba. At that time it was gravel road. Now it's all been paved. And the ranch house sits almost in the center of the picture in that far group of trees. This is a sweep up back of the ranch. The fields. Another closer up view. Elba's in the distance. And the mountains there are Independence Lakes. This is a view of the ranch sitting in the trees. And some of the outbuildings out behind. The ranch house is of log construction. This is a view down the valley towards Malta. In the center was a little store at the corners, Ward Store. Here's an early view of Tom riding. And here's our gatekeeper. items. Alan and his little Confederate hat. This is a view of the yard out back of the ranch house. This is a scene of Jess helping at the time to put together a small storage silo for grain. One scene of Zette, this is before she was married. Tom taking some corn shucks out to the cattle. This is a view of the flower beds in back of the ranch house there. Mom had, it was hollyhocks, sweet williams. View of Jess trying to make a little pony there do a little trick. And Patsy and Tim trying to get on board. And there's a picture of my wife and I. Mom and ours coming from the orchard. They had a lot of apple trees out back, and everybody used to harvest apples up there. Here's a little pony cart that Jess put together with kids. Tim and Tom was riding on it, and Timmy Bankson was on the far side, not too good a view of him. The following scenes now coming up are from the City of Rocks, out south of Oakley. And it was from around 1954. At one time, they used to celebrate out there in the City of Rocks, Oakley did, and they'd pick a beauty queen and from their celebration, and the beauty queen was crowned in a place called Bathtub Rock up in the City of Rocks. This hasn't been done many years, though, now, so we decided to go out there, though, and see. It's quite a desert atmosphere. Here's Isla trying to do some cliffhanging. Pretty rough country out there, really. Here's a group way down below us coming up the hill towards the city. The rocks, the bathtub rock, what they call bathtub rock. And there's the depression in the rock, which was called bathtub rock. We got Leela and Melba and Chrissy. We told her, you're taking a bath. Take a bath. Wash your hands. Short distance behind the ranch house, up on a mountain called Mount Hamilton, is Lake Cleveland. Nowadays, you can drive into the lake. In those days, we had to walk in. Lake was a very good lake for fishing. In later years, Tom and I and several of us went up there and got a lot of limits of fish. These scenes was taken about 1952. There was Jess and Bernice out there on lake on a raft, which they found at the upper end of the lake. Arzetta, Alan, and Nadine. It was cold and windy that day. Over the mountain from Mom's, going west, is Oakley. And this scene pans up the valley towards Basin, towards the Basin. Over here is where Bill and Melba had their ranch, and lived in those days. This is about 1952. This is the brick ranch house. An early scene of Chrissy. Thank you. already seen of Larry. This is Bill's Jeep. While there, Bill and I took a trip, went back in from the ranch to the Independence Lakes. They set in behind that high peak, which you see in the foreground. That peak's called Cache Peak. There was very little road in there in those days. We just went in over the rough rocks, whatever we could get in, however we could get in. Now I understand today that the road has all been bulldozed out and you have to hike in now. The cabins that was in there have all been torn out. It's called a remote area now. Up on top, we can look east over Elba, out east towards where the Beauty Ranch is. Getting late in the afternoon, sun is starting to set. We got out of there just about nightfall. This is the scene of the church in Elba where three of the girls in our whole family was all blessed. We had my girl, Jan, there was Gwenda and Gwenda Payne and Roxanne Hale. And they was all blessed here by ours Udy on the same day. Nevertheless, it sure swelled the attendance of that church for that day. I think there was some 78 family members there. After the blessing, we went up to the ranch and we had a large dinner at the ranch. There's Tom. This was taken about 1956. Most of these scenes I'm showing you all seem to be family get-togethers, and I wouldn't want anybody to get the impression that all we seem to do in this family is eat. But unfortunately, that's where most of our pictures are taken, during family get-togethers. There's Aunt Sadie. And Aunt Burr. An early picture of Larry and his girlfriend. I don't know her name, unfortunately. Picture time. Everybody turning out for pictures. Picture time. These scenes here are from, I think, the ranch in the wintertime. That was ours out washing his car. About 1960. Here's the twins, grown up quite a bit now with the car that Jack gave them. Picture of Jan and Isla, giving Jan a taste of the horse. Best old horse ever was. Every kid, I think, at that time had ridden Colonel. Careful, I'm the cameraman. Even I had a turn at it. One of the few horses, really, I can ride pretty well. I'm not a horse person. While we was there, Jan got a chance to play with the calfies. That's Mom Udy out there feeding the calves. This is Bill and Melba's ranch place, a few scenes. This was taken in the 50s. I don't know when in the 50s, but we'll just have to say about the mid-50s. There was a bridge going over the irrigation ditch, brought water down by the ranch. Virginia up there on the swing. And this was Melba coming home. Bonnie. Should have been up to the hot springs. I had a hot springs in a place the upper end. She'd go up there and go swimming. Well, not really swimming. You can't swim in the hot springs, but go hot tubbing, I guess you might say, in today's world. This is Larry helping Bill farm in those days. Now we come to Whitaker's new home in Twin Falls. And here comes Donald Jr. on his paper route. kind of a slim, trim kid in those days. Was Alan on crutches. He got to where he could run on those crutches faster than I could walk. Here's early scenes again of the ranch in winter. It's taken around 1960. There was the library. Velma Jean and Bonnie, two grown-up nice looking young ladies. There's Bobby. Newlyweds. Rex the dog. Tom and Tim. I think this is where they took their base mechanics on this car. I think it was put together quite a few times. Donald Jr. and his wife, Joyce. Was Alan and wrestling with Jan. All the kids loved to play with Alan because he was full of energy and he would really tease him and play with him and turn him around. Nadine, hold still. I want to get your picture. Okay. now shift our activities to the year 1962, to north of Twin Falls, to Lake Alturas. We went up there on the 4th of July to have a family get together, and lo and behold, we woke up on July 4th and to a winter wonderland. This is Jan coming out to survey it. The snow didn't last too long. It disappeared shortly after lunch. We was then able to go down and enjoy the lake. This is a view of one of the cabins that we stayed in. There's a picture of Brian going over to the main cabin that morning where we was having lunch, or having breakfast rather. And there was Don's station wagon. His boat, and Jack was riding happy July 4th on the snow. While Jan was putting more snow on the watermelons, we had to keep them cool. We just got them out of the creek, which is ice cold. Brent. And that morning, Alan come up from Twin on his motorcycle, and he was cool. Yeah, it's Chrissy. She went over to the boat, brought out the water skis, and decided to try them for snow. Might as well. We had snow. Mom and Nadine. And down to the lake in the afternoon and try a little water skiing. That was Donald Jr. taking off there. The water skis. And there goes Tim. You didn't dare fall down, you'd freeze to death. So they had to take off right from the dock. Don doing a few turns with his boat. Briefly, and no, I'm sorry, we go north to Redfish Lake for a few scenes here with Tom and Diane and Isla and I think Leela. There was Jan out there in the lake, crystal clear but cold. Jan and Brian. Leaving there, we come down to Ketchum. Stop there briefly at a heated pool. Hot springs, I understand, heat the water. So we stopped in there and had a little swim. That's my boy, Brian. There's Donald Jr. Arzetta. And now we go down to Burley. This is the early 60s. It's the boat dock at Burley on the Snake. There's Bill's camper, at the time, his boat. Jan and Kim. Don had his boat there also. There's a dock takeoff. There's Bill and Roy Bankson, Mom, Rosetta and Isla. And we have we can't all be perfect. Bill was an excellent water skier. It's just that I caught him the one time that he fell down. This is Mom's house in Burley in the early 60s. There's Ford parked out front. Bill and Melba now own the house. Early scenes of Tim tuning up the cars. And in the garage, laying down, relaxing, Tom. We now go down to Melba's. Melba and Bill had just recently bought a home in Burley. So we celebrated there with a dinner there. There was Roy carrying Kim. She got injured a little bit in a boat accident that day. There was ours. Just received a coat that Leela had knitted, put together for him special. It had a large cow on the back. And it had the UD brand, AJ brand on the sleeves. Very creative. He was very proud of that. He'd wear it to the cattle auctions. This is the backyard at Bill and Melba's. There again, we're always eating. There's Timmy Bankson. Wilma, Don, ours, Mom, Mom and Diane. Roy and Kim. And Leela. Bill. Donald III. Going down towards Reno Way, we stopped in briefly and saw Justin Shirley. This was taken around 1963. It was Roxanne. Rhonda. Jan and Brian. We tried all the horses that trip. There's a nice picture of Jess and little pony. These scenes here was of a family get-together, in a sense, but not very pleasant. It was during the time of Claire's funeral, 1972, at our home in Saratoga. There's Tim, John, Linda, yes. Zeta and Mom. Melba. Tom, Don. All the kids in the pool. Coming so fast, I can't identify them all. Thank you. Nova. Who? Oh, Sue. Yeah. And Sue. The quality of these pictures here are not very good, but I did not want to discard them. There's Dennis. There's Daryl and Kim. And that's Kim again. Jess, Daryl, and Kim. There's Bill, his camera. There's Robbie up on top. Rhonda. Gwen. Zet and Jim. Sue. Mitchell. Gwen and Roxanne.
Hi. They asked me.
Thank you. Why don't we have everybody?
A few things I do want to cover, the most important of those being this little jewel here. And I'm not going to make you wear them unless you would like to wear one. But in the event that you do not wear one, I want you to be aware of how they go on. And I want you to be aware of where they can be found in the event of an emergency, which obviously this boat has never had, or we wouldn't be sitting in it right now. It wouldn't be floating. They go on just like this. They're uncomfortable. Make it hard. Well, thank you for coming. I'd like to welcome you to Hell's Canyon, and in welcoming you to Hell's Canyon, I may as well welcome you to the deepest low relief canyon in the world. By low relief, I mean that pick any mountain peak that you have seen since you left Oxbow and that you will see on this tour, and it's a false top. By that, I mean that if you were to climb to the top of, oh, there's a tall one down there. If you were to climb to the top of that, there would be another mountain behind it that was taller. You've got two. Yeah, the Seven Devils on the Idaho side, with He Devil in the Seven Devils, rising up to 9,393 feet. With a lot of trading with their neighbors, they made their living.
Thank you. on, Best.
It's got Daddy's eyes, but the rest of them, it's me.
I thought they were already here.
Sarah.
Smile. Joseph, you were supposed to be looking at her.
That's too much, Steve.
Get lazy to fly.
As soon as Donnie gets back with the ping pong balls, we'll start some games. I think we got a weak spot.
Get out from April.
I was dead there, wasn't
I? I can't blow it. I can't move it.
Come on, Mom.
No, blow. Oh.
That's all right. It doesn't count.
You better be glad.
I'm glad I'm not you.
Come on. Well, you're not. Come on.
We're supposed to go that way, you said.
Yeah, you are.
No, I'm going. Oh, there.
There. You.
There, there.
Clear down the end.
Oh, I'm good. That's okay. It didn't go down far enough. Hey, my shoulder's up there.
Whoa.
We can put our
ready, set,
there.
Go.
Whoa. Come on.
Where do you think? Go.
Come on, Shirley.
Here's one down here.
Who's all these people?
Because there's Reed and Jeannie.
I don't know.
Christy and Laura. And Claudius and mine.
Get Michael coming in. That was my Kyle. Get over. Have Michael.
Diane.
Donnie, you better get every one of us in there. Donnie, you better get every one of us in there.
Better be down there.
Okay.
That's pretty good. Jerry, how about looking this way here? Good to see y'all. And there's Walter, and there's Russell, and who else we got?
Betsy.
Oh, and Betsy's back there. Okay, hi, Betsy. These are Milton's children. There's Sean standing in the background right there. Sean? Hi, Diane.
Randy.
Who's that? Is that Randy?
Randy. I know
him. I wouldn't have known Randy.
Mr. Rocky.
Where's Rocky?
He's
one of the best. Okay. Where's Rocky?
Brother.
Here's Milton, just walk for me.
Yeah?
That looks like Burns has been Keith Simons. This is Melvin, and what was your name?
This is
Joy Lynn. Okay. It's Marilyn's older brother.
Michelle.
Uh-huh. Is that you, Janelle? Hi, Janelle. I'll get over and give you a hug in a minute. This is Randy's family here. Janelle's the wife. Okay, we're ready.
I'm Cammie Bissell, George's daughter.
living, Cammy?
I live in Spokane, and I have two kids, one 17 and one 5.
Oh, good. It's sure good to see you. Okay.
I'm Michelle. I'm Rocky's daughter. I'm 19, and I'm living in Boise.
And you're single?
Yes.
You're available then?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Okay.
Postcard should be sent too.
Good to see. It's going now, so if you'd tell me. You're Eileen.
Eileen Lee. I was Eileen Lee and Mary Clinton.
Okay. And who was with Mother when she died?
Mother.
Thelma Lee.
You're Thelma. Okay, Thelma. And tell me your ages, lady.
What?
How old are you?
87.
Oh, goodness. You sure look good. You both look so good. It's sure good to see you both again.
The daughter Michelle here.
Yeah, I got room in to go. Okay.
No kidding.
And who's
Cammy. This is Cammy and Marlene.
Okay. Good.
We live in Boise.
Okay, it's good to see you, bro.
Yeah, good to see you, too.
Okay.
Just walk through.
Okay. Deamer.
Yeah, one of this here, too.
Carrie and Shirley. Reed just got here. Hi, Brittany. Hi, Betty. It's good to see you again.
I remember you being here.
Yes. Valerie, give him a hug. Just talk to her from out there. Hey, Valerie. Tell Gina hello.
Hi. Her Aunt Gina's not here.
No, she
is.
Okay, Kay talking to Joyce Goodman. That is Jay's wife. That's Jay Little. This is Clyde Goodman here. And this is Kate Goodman. Okay, this is Fern's daughter, Kareem. And this is her little daughter. Mike just got here. Mike? Hey, Mike? So anyway, tell me again now, this Carol, and you live where, Carol? You're Mildred's daughter. Okay.
And where do you...
Well, good. I'm glad to have you both on tape. I'm going to look at this a lot. This is Bishop Allen. George is in the bishopric with him. And he's a relation to the Egberts. He's the other Murtaugh. Tell.
Michael.
Want to say hello to Gina?
Hi, Aunt Gina. We miss you. See you in August.
Three police cars.
I don't know.
The day and they're coming now. Got to visit with a number of you. This is such a beautiful spot here, right under this great big weeping willow tree and right here by the creek. I understand that Marilyn really took some time to pick out a special place for him here.
I did fine until I saw the state trip.
Well, Sure glad Roby could attend today. Looks good. He says to tell you hello, honey. Do you want to say anything to Gina? You want to say anything to Gina?
Pardon?
You want to say anything to Gina?
Yeah, tell her I love her.
I will.
To be grateful.